Since the earliest of societies, thinkers have attempted to define the age of human existence, of the world, and of the universe. After many millennia, contemporary scientists have been able to accurately estimate the universe's age to be 13.772 billion years, give or take 21 million years. But how did humans reach this conclusion, and how did their ideas develop over time? To discuss this, one must first start around 4500 BCE. Before I begin, many of the beliefs I will talk about often blend the creation of mankind, the creation of the Earth, and the creation of the universe together. It's not until much closer to the present day that scientists and thinkers began differentiating between the three separate events. This is why I will often use the term seemingly interchangeably, but the terminology is solely based on the specific society about which I am talking. To begin with, the Sumerian civilization, throughout their existence, created a list of their kings, ranging from ancient rulers to ones that held power shortly before Sumer's downfall. The earliest kings on the list, like the first ruler Alulim, were stated to have governed for thousands of years each. The Sumerians believed that the earth was created and then Alulim took power shortly after. They also believed that a massive flood swept over the earth after the ancient kings had ruled. This flood, according to radiocarbon dating, appears to have actually occurred. Scientists date it at 2900 BCE. By adding the lengths of rule of the ancient Sumerian kings together, getting 241,200 years, and adding that to the date 2900 BCE, scientists estimate that Sumerians believe the Earth started existing in 244,100 BCE. Yet Sumerians did not really believe in a specific chronology, so the date 244,100 BCE is more of a coincidental date based on fabricated lengths of rule. Similar to the Sumerians, the Egyptians had a king list. Their list describes a period when only gods ruled, and this period lasted 36,620 years until the first dated king, Menes, who ruled starting at 3050 BCE. Therefore, the creation of the Earth would be dated around 39,670 BCE. Several other Egyptian sources and subsequent Greek attempts at analyzing Egyptian chronology provide various other dates for the start of the Earth. It's also important to note that the Egyptians were rather vague on whether the creation to which they referred was the creation of man or the creation of the Earth itself. Either way, the most conservative estimate was that the universe was 11,340 years old, while the largest considered the cosmos to be 153,075 years old. Like the Egyptians, the Greeks and Romans typically avoided a strict date for the universe's origin. Furthermore, there were a large variety of ages thrown about during both civilizations' time, and some thinkers even believe that the universe was simply eternal and had no beginning. However, most Greek and Roman scholars did divide history into three periods: Adelon, Mythicon, and Historicon. The Adelon period stretches from the creation of mankind to a large flood, the Mythicon period from the flood to the first Olympiad, and the Historicon period from the Olympiad to their own present time. Despite providing dates for nearly all of the events in this chronology, most of the thinkers admitted that no one really knew the exact date of creation and avoided such a literal view. They considered the Adelon period to have ended around 2376 BCE, meaning that they believed mankind, not necessarily the universe, to be created some time before this. Next in line to place a date on creation was Zoroastrianism, one of the world's oldest and more prominent religions. Zoroastrians divide their chronology into four periods that span about 12,000 years, each period lasting about 3,000 years. The first period included spiritual creation, while the second period was the physical creation that saw the earth come into existence. They believe that Zoroaster, the religion's founder, to have been born at the end of the third period, his birth marking the beginning of the fourth and final era. This means that the universe, and from their perspective, the spiritual world, was created about 9,000 years before Zoroaster's birth. While there are competing beliefs about his birth date, it was generally accepted that he was born about 600 BCE, but now historians believe that he may have lived much earlier in the 10th century BCE. Using the traditional date, Zoroastrians would have therefore believed that the universe was created in about 9600 BCE. Spanning many of the previously mentioned societies and onto the present day, Hinduism provides a different take on the universe's origin. According to the Vedic tradition, the universe has no beginning nor end. Instead, the universe is driven by infinite cycles of birth followed by destruction. The Rig Veda, an ancient collection of Vedic hymns, frequently asks how the universe was created, if at all. For example, at one point it states that a golden child was born and later established both earth and heaven. Yet, it later asks if anyone truly knows how the universe came into being. It even asserts a multiverse theory in which infinite universes exist like the atoms within each human. Hinduism's unique cosmological beliefs make it the first of old religions to relate closely with modern cosmology. Famed scientist Carl Sagan himself admired the Hindu beliefs relating to cosmology. A Chinese historian in the 3rd century dated the creation of the world 36,000 years before a series of mythical rulers in China. These rulers were said to hold power from 3000 to 2700 BCE, meaning that the universe would have been created at about 39,000 BCE. In addition, the Mayan people in Mesoamerica, known for their calendar and precise astronomical observations, estimated that the human world was created in 3114 BCE. Interestingly, a stela, or a Mayan stone slab bearing inscriptions, possibly dates the universe's creation to 24 trillion years in the past. The Jewish faith, the first of the Abrahamic religions, followed the creation story in the Bible's book of Genesis. This became widely known as Anno Mundi, or the calendar era based on biblical accounts of creation. This book actually contains two separate creation stories, but like many of the previously mentioned groups, interpretations of Genesis failed to determine an exact year for the universe's birth. Yet, one early Jewish estimate of the Earth's creation considered it to have begun in 2761 BCE. Following this early approximation, the Abrahamic tradition split into two separate groups. The Jewish faith adopted the Masoretic text, their literary canon, while the new Christian faith followed the Septuagint, the Greek translation of the Old Testament. The Masoretic text dates creation around 4000 BCE, and an archbishop's specific chronology of dating the creation to 4004 BCE became widely accepted across the Jewish faith. As for the Christians, they accepted the date 5500 BCE, with many thinkers adding or subtracting several years to that specific date. The next significant attempt at dating the universe began at the start of the Enlightenment. In fact, it began with advancements in geology. As scientists analyzed the relationship between fossils, strata, and age, they therefore estimated the Earth to be about 96 million years old, and with each discovery, that number was increased. While this certainly proved the Earth to be much older than previously thought, many scientists in the 19th and early 20th century thought the universe was eternal, with stars, planets, and other objects simply being created and existing until an eventual destruction that was at a different time for each thing. However, as the theories of thermodynamics began to take hold, this idea of an infinite universe slowly dissipated. This was due to the fact that if the universe was infinitely old, then everything inside should be the same temperature, according to entropy. If you want to learn more about this, definitely check out my other video, which you can find right here. In 1915, Albert Einstein developed his theory of general relativity and built a cosmological model based upon his theory. He added a constant to be consistent with the idea of an infinitely old universe, but this cosmological model was eventually disproven by various scientists. Nearing the mid-20th century, scientists like Edwin Hubble noticed that other galaxies were moving quickly away from our own Milky Way. This was the first piece of direct evidence proving that the universe was indeed not static, but instead much more dynamic as it expanded. Using the Hubble constant, a numerical value of the universe's estimated rate of expansion, scientists attempted to show how the age of the universe was older than that of the oldest star, which they thought was 25 billion years old. They could never reconcile the Hubble constant with that star's age, which was indeed incorrect. The Hubble constant was frequently adapted, but for many years, the age of the universe simply could not be discovered. That is, until a major breakthrough occurred in 1965. In 1965, two teams of scientists coincidentally reached similar conclusions by chance. They both detected noise that they realized was radiation left over from the Big Bang, dubbed cosmic microwave background, therefore proving the Big Bang theory correct. In the 1990s, the Hubble constant was revised to be a more precise value, and a series of discoveries lowered the age of the oldest stars, solving the reconciliation problem. When the standard model of the universe was adopted, dark energy, a significant component of the model, was accepted. This dark energy explains that the universe was expanding more slowly around half its present age than today. In 2001, the Wilkinson Microwave Anisotropy Probe, or WMAP, was launched and led to an estimate of 13.772 billion years of age with only 0.3% uncertainty. And with that estimate, the millennia-long problem of the universe's age was resolved.